left here, boy, take it slow. Don't get distracted by that radio. I just rolled my eyes and I said, Daddy, I know. I'm 15, I ain't green like some old 10-year-old. What I wouldn't give to be 16, wild and free, cruising up and down Maine in my F-150. Roll the windows down, bass too loud from this burned CD. I'll be right where I wanna be when I'm 16, 16, yeah. 16. Now that I can drive, finally feel alive, but I got this curfew. Sneaking in late, smelling like my girlfriend's perfume. People talking about college and knowledge, and that's alright. But all I'm thinking about is an unsupervised Saturday night. What I wouldn't give to be 18. Buzzing off a can of that grizzly wintergreen. Looking old enough to pull off this fake ID. I'll be right where I wanna be when I'm 18, 18, yeah. 18, yeah. I'm old enough to smoke, I'm old enough to vote, but they turn me away. They say the grass is always greener, and I believe that's right. But my friends are off to Vegas, and they're leaving me behind. What I wouldn't give to be 21, wild and free. Open up a cold one and drink it legally. Chase a bunch of girls, go see the world, let my wild streak run. I'll be right where I wanna be when I'm 21, 21. Oh, when I'm 21, yeah, when I'm 21, it'll be alright, yeah, it'll all be alright when I'm 21. Now I'm 25 and I'm drinking wine with my wife at home. Got a couple dogs and a couple songs on the radio. And we sit around and we laugh about how we used to be, when all we cared about was turning 16.
She was staring out the window of their SUV, complaining, saying, I can't wait to turn 18. She said, I'll make my own money and I'll make my own rules. Mama put the car in park out there in front of the school. And she kissed her head and said, I was just like you. You're gonna miss this. You're gonna want this back. You're gonna wish these days hadn't gone by so fast. These are some good times, so take a good look around. You may not know it now, but you're gonna miss this. Before she knows it, she's a brand new bride in her one-bedroom apartment, and her daddy stops by. He tells her it's a nice place. She says, it'll do for now. Starts talking about babies and buying a house. Daddy shakes his head and says, baby, just slow down. You're gonna miss this. You're gonna want this back. You're gonna wish these days hadn't gone by so fast. These are some good times, so take a good look around. You may not know it now, but you're gonna miss this. He says, they don't bother me. I've got two babies of my own. One's 36, one's 23. It's hard to believe, but you're gonna miss this. You're gonna want this back. You're gonna wish these days hadn't gone by so fast. These are some good times, so take a good look.
Thinking about the fans, we were underground, loading merch in that 12 passenger van in a small club in Minnesota, and the snow outside of First Ave. I just wanted my name in the star. Now look at where we at, still growing up, still growing up. I would lay in my bed and dream about what I'd become. Couldn't wait to get older, couldn't wait to be some. Now that I'm here, wishing I was still young. Those good old days.
Told me, babe, that someday these would be the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. Cause someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of the good old days.
Wish I didn't think I had the answers. Wish I didn't drink all of that glass first. Wish I made it to homecoming. Got up the courage to ask her. Wish I would have gotten out of my show. Wish I put the bottle back on that shelf. Wish I wouldn't have worried about what other people thought and felt comfortable with myself. Rooftop open and the stars above. Moment frozen, sneaking out and falling in love. Me, you, and that futon. We just begun. On the grass dreaming, figuring out who I was. Those good old days.
I wish somebody would have told me, babe, that someday these would be the good old days. All the love you won't forget, and all these reckless nights you won't regret. Cause someday soon your whole life's gonna change. You'll miss the magic of the good old days.
Never thought we'd get old. Maybe we're still young. Maybe you always look back and think it was better than it was. Maybe these are the moments. Maybe I've been missing what it's about. Been scared of the future, thinking about the past while missing out on now. We've come so far, I guess I'm proud. And I ain't worried about the wrinkles around my smile. I got some scars, I've been around. I felt some pain, I seen some things, but I'm here now. Those good old days.
You don't know what you got, whoa, whoa, till it goes, whoa, whoa, till it's gone.
You entered into the uncertain world of September 11th. Meeting challenges and overcoming obstacles ever since. When you arrived at Wells Elementary School, you showed off your charisma and personality at every turn. You learned to read and write and how to add and subtract. You negotiated the playground and established friendships that will last a lifetime. You danced, you sang, and you brought Broadway alive. When you moved over to Route 1, Wells Junior High welcomed you with open arms. You joined intramurals, clubs, and activities and started to carve your niche. You researched leaves, you battled in lip sync, faced off in spelling and geography, and coupled up for the first school dance, all before you were off to high school. Your class was the very first group to make the new Wells High School home for all 4 years. Here you became published writers, celebrated musicians and performers, nationally recognized scholars. You won awards, you placed in competitions. You brought championship gold home to Wells. You made history here, a history etched into the memories of all of us who watched you grow. Class of 2020, you changed our towns of Wells and Ogunquit for the good. We're proud of the human beings you've become, and we look forward to following the journey that began here in Wells and Ogunquit. Carl Jung, the Swiss psychologist, once noted, "I am not what has happened to me. I am what I choose to become." Congratulations, class of 2020. Go become.
We are extremely proud of this special senior class. You will be remembered forever. There is a saying that tough times never last, tough people do. That is never more appropriate than in times that we are in now. The class of 2020, you are strong, you are resilient, and we will get through these times together. We are so very proud of you and the way you've handled the end of your senior year. Enjoy the show.
Thank you.
To perform our national anthem, please welcome Eliana Poulin.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Distinguished faculty, guests, family and friends, good evening and welcome to the 117th Wells High School Commencement Exercises. I would like to say thank you to Superintendent Daly for his unwavering leadership and support in these challenging times. I would also like to say thank you to the Wells Ogunquit Community School Board, Chair Helena Ackerson, Vice Chair Jason Vinard, members Boriana Dolliver, Heather Satig, and Anelia Georgieva Petrov. Each of you have extended your constant and unyielding support throughout these extraordinary times. I would like to give a very special thank you to Matt Roberge and the Saco Drive-In for offering their venue for tonight's celebration. I would also like to say thank you to Matt Booth and Majestic Video Services for their extremely talented videography that allows us to enjoy our Wells High School commencement exercises in a very enjoyable way all together this evening on the big screen. I would like to give a very special thanks to Mrs. Webster, Mrs. Staples, Mrs. Ward, and Mrs. Sanborn for all their support and attention to the details that have led up to this evening's special event. I would also like to say thank you to Mr. Malloy, Mr. Luia, Mrs. Graceffa, Mr. Adams, Michael Richards, Steve Seveny, John Murray, Officer Regal, and Officer Long. They worked diligently to ensure every single task was attended to on our videotaping day, May 26th. A huge thank you goes to Robin Reedy, who offered her photography services on our filming day. Mrs. Reedy's generous giving will allow every senior to receive an on-the-stage graduation photo this year. Assistant Principal Gould and class advisors Mr. and Mrs. Roach have worked tirelessly to ensure our seniors experience the very best possible celebrations this year. I would like to acknowledge the citizens of Wells Ogunquit who continually support our students and our schools through their contributions and time and resources. Due to their gracious and generous giving of our community, we were able to distribute over $100,000 in scholarships to our graduates on Monday evening. A huge thank you goes to Mrs. Lawler for her many hours of work that were dedicated to the organization and communications of this year's record-breaking scholarship process. To our Wells High School 2020 graduates, on behalf of the administration, The faculty, staff, and students at Wells High School, and indeed the entire Wells-Algonquin Community School District, congratulations to each and every one of you. You are compassionate, resourceful, skilled, and dedicated young adults. You have sacrificed much in these recent months. The sudden transition to distant learning in March was something none of us saw coming. While it may have been challenging at times, you remain resilient, connected, and productive. Beyond the academic expectations, you were forced to learn nothing is promised, and then to learn that, well, maybe there are some things we all take a little bit for granted. Yet in the face of tremendous adversity, you remained a warrior. Over the course of your 4 years at Wells High School, you have accomplished much in your academics, your athletics, and visual and performing arts. Each year, you have been acclaimed members of our band and chorus and color guard and bringing home numerous awards. You have created award-winning artwork and shared it within our school community. Again this year, you have been members of regional and state championships, specifically in wrestling, and in the first ever for our women's basketball team. As a class, you have given hundreds and hundreds of hours of community service far and above the requirement for graduation. You have helped to raise thousands of dollars for many charities. In our own community of Wells-Algonquin, you have supported our very own citizens with donations to various food pantries, Thanksgiving and Christmas dinners. You've hosted many turkey dinners, attended many community beautification events, and you've given hundreds of hours of service to various community-based events helping senior citizens and in our elementary school through our Acorns to Oaks and Trendsetters and other mentoring and recreation programs. We are deeply grateful for every contribution you have made to our school and our community. In these current times in which we find ourselves, we all give tremendous thanks to our essential workers on the front lines. Additionally, during this world pandemic, there is a mission brewing for you, the graduates of 2020. You have instantaneously become our essential learners. You will now be the generation that uses their critical thinking, discipline, and perseverance to bring new meaning to our world. You will shape the way we rebuild our economic strength, and you will impact how we engineer a future to combat challenges such as the one in which we find ourselves today. As freshmen, you never could have fathomed the vital position in which you would find yourselves at the close of your senior year. But indeed, you are the generation that will lead the change in healing our world. You have abundantly contributed to our tradition of excellence at Wells High School. You've worked diligently and sometimes painstakingly to get to where you are today. You have overcome both personal and academic challenges, and you have steadily focused on your responsibilities, and consistently you have stayed true to your intention to produce great results. There is no doubt you are unstoppable. There is a famous quote, and you may have heard it, life is 10% what happens and 90% how you respond. As your senior year is drawn to a close, you have responded with incredible courage and character. Your hard work has paid off. We salute you, the Wells High School class of 2020. Remember, the harder you work, the luckier you get. The more you get done, the less you'll regret. Write it down
so you never forget. The harder you work, the luckier you get. To deliver our valedictorian address, please welcome Gwen Wallingford.
Good evening and welcome parents, family, teachers, administrators, and the Wells High School class of 2020. It's an honor to be able to speak at our graduation, even if it's in a video. First, I would like to start by saying thank you to all the people that have helped not just me personally, but our whole class throughout our school years. Without the support and encouragement from teachers, staff, family, and friends, we wouldn't be where we are today. Thank you to all of the teachers and staff for making it your goal to push us to always try our best and help us recognize our potential. You've given us a huge amount of support and guidance, especially in these last few months, with all the adjustments that we have had to go through. You've worked extremely hard to make sure that no one falls behind while learning online and face the challenges that have come with this sudden switch. Thank you to my family and the families of our whole class for always being there and supporting us in everything that we do. We are grateful for it, even if we don't always take the time to show it. And lastly, thank you to my friends for always being there for me and for making every school day more interesting. They mean the world to me, and I wouldn't be the person that I am today without them. Obviously, this is not the way we all imagine our graduation day would look like, sitting in our own cars at a drive-in watching our graduation on a screen. But at least we can all still be here together to watch it and experience it, even if we can't all be sitting next to each other. Because that is what graduation is supposed to be all about, celebrating all we have accomplished so far and everything that we will achieve in the future. It's about reflecting on the years we have spent together while also looking ahead at what each of us will go on to do with our lives. Even though we are all going on different paths, going to different colleges, even different states, we will always share the memories that we have made in our years at this school and the experience of our graduation that is so different from past years. Throughout the 4 years we have attended this high school, we have all accomplished so much. We have earned numerous academic and athletic achievements, from book awards to state championships. And with all of our community service hours, we've given back to the community that has supported us during our high school career. We've shown our creativity through artwork, acting, writing, and so much more. But most importantly, we have grown and changed as individuals since the first day that we came to the school as freshmen. I know that I definitely have. Those of you who know me know that I have always hated public speaking, so giving a speech like this was basically my worst nightmare. But even though I still dislike having to speak in front of people, I've become a more confident person in my time at Wells High School. I'm sure that all of you can think back to the person you were freshman year and how you have grown and become a more independent young adult over these last 4 years. Although we have done many things in our time in high school, we will all go on to do so much more in the years ahead. Regardless of whether you choose to go to college, take a gap year, or go straight to employment, you will all have so many opportunities to achieve whatever goals you have for yourself. If we carry the hard work and dedication that we have put into these last 4 years of school on with us to our next stage in life, we can all accomplish whatever we set our minds to. And if you ever doubt yourself, just think about how you made it through online learning and quarantine. You put in the work for your classes every day, even when your motivation was at an all-time low. If you can get through this, then you can get through anything that life throws your way. Thank you all for listening, and I wish the class of 2020 the best of luck in whatever path you all choose to take.
To deliver the address from Wells Elementary School, please welcome Donna Longley.
Hello, and thank you for inviting me here today to be part of this historic event. Wells Elementary School was the start for many of you. You came to kindergarten all dressed up, some of you terrified of being away from mommy and daddy, some shed tears, some of you were eager to learn, eager to make new friends, eager to carry a lunchbox and a backpack, especially if they matched, because how cool was that? You learned to share, you learned to work and play together, and to be part of a team. You learned about kindness and fairness. You thought that to be fair meant that everyone got the same, that everything should be equal. Like when someone brings in bacon to share with the class, and everyone gets a piece. That was very thoughtful and kind. Then one person gives theirs to someone else who already has bacon. Many perceive that as unfair, unless you are the one that got the extra bacon. Right, Mia? In kindergarten, you had a concert. You sang songs and recited poems. In first grade, you performed Tiki Tiki Tembo or Three Piggy Opera with your class. This year, they didn't get to. In second grade, you performed Rodeo with some kids from the junior high. This year, they had a virtual Rodeo. I'm not really sure how you square dance virtually. In third grade, you learned how to play the recorder and had a concert. This year, we had a Zoom concert where only one person's mic was turned on at a time. In fourth grade, you came together as a class and put on Stars for Broadway. and started to understand that life isn't fair. Not everyone gets the lead or the solo or that special costume, but you made it work as a class with Mrs. Taylor's help, of course, but not this year. They had barely practiced the intro and the finale when we left on March 13th. No class numbers, no solos. It's not fair. And it's just not the thing you can do virtually. It's not fair that you worked for 13 long years to get to this point in your life, only to have all the senior rites of passages taken away. It's not fair you didn't have a prom, senior skip day, or maybe you did that virtually. I don't know how that would work. It's not fair that you don't get to have a regular convocation down at Ogunquit Playhouse where I would get to poke fun at you. At WES, we look forward to seeing you all parade through the school in your gowns, seeing how much you've grown, barely recognizable from the kids you were just 13 years ago, our students looking up at you with awe in their eyes. They do look up to you, and not just because you're way taller than them. Fairness is an act of thinking mostly of oneself. Did I get whatever? Kindness, however, is an act of thinking of others. What can I do to put my selfishness aside and make this work? You have adapted and made these rites of passage your own. You didn't sit back and let this happen to you. The activities may look a little different, but different is okay. You're resilient and creative. You work as a team, and that is exactly what you're going to need in this world that is changing faster than ever. There are so many things that have been changed due to the pandemic, but here you are, graduating. You made it. Good luck to you all, and thank you.
To deliver the address from Wells Junior High School, please welcome Ellen Rodman.
I am so excited to share this moment with you. Thank you for inviting me, and thank you to Jim Daly and to the staff here at Wells High School for making this beautiful and possible for you today. So I started to think about my chat with you today when Mrs. Roach so kindly got in contact with me just recently. And you know, once you leave that campus over here and come to this campus over here, it's like you moved to a different country. That's all I can tell you. Seriously, once you leave Wells Junior High School, we can attend your games, we can come to your plays, we can read about you in the newspaper, hopefully not the public safety piece, we can see you in line at Dunkin' Donuts or Aroma Joe's, please watch that caffeine, my friends, but we do lose track. So I was asking myself, literally asking myself. So this class, 2020, let's see, 2016. This class has Logan Bedell in it. I'll never forget her because she was the most positive student I've ever had. Oh, and Renee Carbonneau. I never knew whether she was gonna laugh or cry when she opened her mouth. And sometimes it was the same thing happening at the same time. Or Zach Steer, he had to be 6 feet tall when he was born, because when I see him now, I just can't believe how fast that happened in just a little under 4 years. And Matt Tufts, the brick wall that he was even in sixth grade. You are an amazing junior high school class. I think you had the largest cross-country team, a great football team, an amazing select chorus, and there were a few good girl basketball players. We all know how that turned out this year. Congratulations. There are so many of you that as I started to think about you, I couldn't come up with all of you. So I went and got your yearbook, your junior high school yearbook. Mr. Pearly, our present assistant principal, was so gracious to come hand it to me in a paper bag, like 12 feet away the other day, so that I could take a look at it. And I wish he were here right now, because this is a true story. He put it in a brown Hannaford bag and he handed it to me, and I said, right, 2016. I flipped it open and I flipped to this page. Seriously. Can you see that? You had dedicated your junior high school yearbook to me. That was like, wow, we have such a connection. And I thought, wow, we've come full circle. yearbook, eighth grade, and now high school. What memories? We all know that everything you ever needed to learn in life, you didn't learn in kindergarten. Sorry to my elementary school counterpart who spoke to you, but you learned it in junior high school. That you came to meet challenges. You came from the elementary school, wide-eyed, maybe the first time having so many teachers, maybe the first time having an interscholastic sport competition with another school, and it really mattered to you. Maybe it was your first dance. Maybe it was your first kiss. Hopefully that wasn't in the health classroom. But I do know that Franny Ramsdell's older brother did hold hands under the table in the health classroom. And I'm not always so sure that's the only thing that went on under the tables in the health classroom. But you became stronger. You became better decision makers. You defied gravity. The pull of being an elementary kid to the gravitational pull of your parents not wanting to let you go, to the gravitational pull now of Wells High School. You defied that gravity, and you went from the terrible twos to the terrible teens, but you defied gravity. You were born during years of some of the most heartbreaking and scary and tumultuous days in our country. You defied that. You grew. You skipped and played at Wells Elementary School, and then you grew and developed through puberty at Wells Junior High School. You were now graduating in a pandemic, another challenging time in our country. You were defying gravity once again. So as I read through your yearbook, I came upon the superlatives. Really? I'm not even sure we still do superlatives, but Cody Dufort is the most likely to break into song? I can picture that from his dad. And you know, I had Kofi's dad as a student. So now I've defied gravity. Thank you, God. I mean, it was no surprise that Grace Bradish was one of the best listeners, that Tyler Evans was one of the best sense of humors. I just recently got rid of your picture on my cell phone from doing this, like, in the middle of the classroom one day while I was teaching something super important. And Ethan Bernhardt, the day you got your braces off, you returned to health class. And that smile. And that was your superlative. So many of you were emerging and becoming you in your high school years. You are strong, you are resilient, you are smart, capable, funny, knowledgeable, artistic, athletic, hopeful, and most of all, you are loved. So to steal the words from the Broadway production of Wicked, Defying Gravity, I won't sing, I promise. And some of you have heard me sing. Something has changed within me. Something is not the same. I'm through with playing by the rules of someone else's game. Too late for second guessing. Too late to go back to sleep. It's time to trust my instincts, close my eyes, and leap. I hope you're happy now that you're choosing this. I hope it brings you bliss. I really hope you get it and don't regret it. I hope you're happy in the end. I hope you're happy, my friend. So if you care to find me, look to the western sky. As someone told me lately, everyone deserves the chance to fly. So you need to carry on and defy that gravity. Take all you have learned and all you have experienced. Congratulations to all of you and your families, and your teachers, to the class of 2020. I wish you good health, great love, complete kindness and happiness, and remarkable success. We all love you at Wells Junior High School. Best wishes.
To deliver the address from Wells High School, please welcome Kevin O'Shaughnessy.
Thank you, Wells Class of 2020, for inviting me to speak at this unique graduation ceremony. I have many memories of your class, but my favorite memory of the class of 2020 happened in my legendary Period 5 World After class. I must have really angered Miss Curcio that year. 23 kids, a cast of characters that led me to redo my seating charts monthly until I finally gave up. They loved to talk, ask questions, and performed. They hated to read, write, and listen. Other than that, we were fine. There was lots of bench, warrior labs, nook placements, every time we had to do research. It drove me crazy. And yet one day, when I was trying to keep them on task, Devin Chase started to sing a song I had never heard before, because I'm old. It was Miley Cyrus's song, The Climb, and everyone joined in. I thought about stopping it, but it was just so wonderfully spontaneous that I just looked around and enjoyed the moment. These young kids sitting in school and singing with their friends for the pure joy of singing and maybe getting out of a little work. But I could tell that this song really meant something to a lot of them. It was something I'll always remember about your class. Now we are just 2 years later in a different situation, one that no class of seniors has had to face ever before. I'm sorry about all the things that go along with graduation that have been lost or changed. Final spring sports, the musical, the top 10 dinner, the parties, the hugs, the high fives. Whether we like it or not, we live in a very different and dangerous time. And right now, sacrifices are being made for us by scientists, hospital workers, first responders, and essential workers to ensure that our lives remain as normal as possible. We must honor those sacrifices by staying together as a community, a state, and most of all, as a country. I'm a history teacher, and I've learned that this country has been at its best when it cared about everybody, not just a chosen few. We got rid of the Articles of Confederation because it led to states fighting each other, and created a constitution because we needed a strong federal government to unify our country. We fought a bloody civil war, which led to the death of over 600,000 Americans because states disagreed about whether slavery was wrong, and it was wrong. We dug ourselves out of the Great Depression and won a world war against Nazi white supremacists because we worked, sacrificed, and rebuilt this country together. Our future is clear. We must stay together. So where does that leave the class of 2020? You've worked so hard. You've achieved so much. But I know you're worried about your future, your college educations, your careers, your lives. Well, Miley Cyrus has some advice for you. Even though your faith is shaken, you got to keep trying. Got to keep your head held high. There's always going to be another mountain, and you're always going to want to make it move. Always going to be an uphill battle. Sometimes you're going to have to lose. Ain't about how fast you get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb. Climb together, class of 2020. Thank you.
Kiara Christine Moisen. Matthew Joseph Guerra Elderkin. Ethan Joseph Shell. Paige Lynn Tremblay. Joel Michael Foley II. Joseph Jeffrey Aramita. Griffin Jason Allaire. Renee Marie Carboneau. Kimberly Elizabeth Yerga. Everett Mason Allen. Matthew William Tufts. Darian Lamar Frazier. Meredith Catherine Bogue. Grace Ann Yolandra Walker. Braden C.V. McNeil. Ash Ryan Dolan. Tyler Kenneth Evans. William David Smith. Ashley Deidre Baldock. Tyler Ethan Carpenter. Mia Marie Draper. Lauren Kuhn. Aiden Gabriel Wood. Abigail Elizabeth Booth. Samantha Jones. Tyson Curtis Springer. Liam Joseph Arell. Alyssa Michelle Wallingford. Gwen Marie Wallingford. Christina Paige Moody. Jack William Lord. Theodore Connolly Pelletier. Grace Margaret Bradish. Hannah Beth Bradish. Bryce Robert McManus. Alexandra Haley Bento. Peyton Bosworth McKay. Timothy John Cashman. Benjamin Robert Coutois. Devin Michael Chase. Joshua Owen Burgess. Cameron Barker. Angelina Jody Balzano. Andrew James Werthner. Daniel John Metzler. Olivia Catherine Michu. Maxwell Nathaniel Gates. Mackenzie Alexandra Webb. Emma Lee Jacqueline Cousins. Ethan Alexander Beals. Alyssa Michelle Kenny. Gus Douglas Madsen. Skyler Kleiner Lozano. Christopher Stewart Moore Jr. Savannah Louise Wilder. Katie Elizabeth Plord. Matthew Dobson Willett. Emily Ann Jarvis. Logan Emily Bedell. Emmanuel Clayton Diggs. Henry Joseph Tefault the Fourth. Eliana Lehman Poulin. Sydney Kevin Belanger. Nathan Michael Mahoney. Tyler Patrick Stapleton. Devin Kimo Bickford. Nathan Thomas Chandler.
Avery Merrill Hubbard. Timothy James McKay. Jaden Dermesh Patel. Zachary Allen Steer. Sarah Ann Webb. Jordan Marlene Belanger.
Taylor Lindsay George. Brian Matthew Roberts. Andrew Jacob Knott. Amazian Klein Conley. Noah Michael Camp. Drew Alexander Stevens. Harrison Edward Briggs. Caitlin Chrisimer. James Michael Luttrell. Jacob Sean Scott. Graham Sumner Bridges. Abigail Louise Durost. Brandon Saperito. Samuel David Chaplin. Michael Daniel Patnode. Summer Riley Sayward. Riley Ann Perrin. Chenille Ashante Eccleston. Ethan Payne Bernhardt. Michael Price. Nathan James Didio. Anthony David Mark DiGiacome. Kaylee Grace Brickett. Francesca Louise Ramsdell. Anna Marie Gould. Wyatt Henry Rao. Evan Michael Leach. Dylan Patrick Roby. Garth Daniel Lamoli. given David McLean. Brody Michael Dempsey. Sarah Alexandra Lord. Alexis Caroline Howes. Caleb Joshua Fenoff. Lucas Robert Reese. Shay Joseph Harrington. Christian Thomas Locklear. Jacobin Andrian Guy Dufort. Frank Michael LaRusso the Fourth. Jade Elizabeth Moffitt. Ethan Chase McAllister. Sydney Lynn Perry. Scott Michael O'Connor. Joshua Martinez. Chaya Annette Lord Rosette. Samuel Bandel Strange. Matthew Chase Regal. Gabriella Marie Zerlo. Summer Ann Shaw. Hannah Grace Wrigley. Madison Jade Tatey.
Please welcome Class President Ashley Bulldog, Class Vice President Dakovan Dufort, and Class Treasurer Joseph Aramita for the presentation of the graduates.
Congratulations, Class of 2020. We did it. Would you all please join me in moving our tassels from the right to the left? Congrats!
Seniors, we're so proud of you all. Can't believe you're done. We're gonna miss you. Zach and TJ, we didn't get to do our jersey day, but maybe this summer the Leafs will pull it off. We'll see. Take care, everybody. Have a great summer. Good luck in the fall. Stay in touch. You did it.
My favorite memories of high school would be playing field hockey and softball with my teammates.
Hey, class of 2020. Just wanted to take a couple of seconds to congratulate you. And just to reflect on when you first came to the high school, and we were marveling at how many of you there were and how much energy you had. We were saying, wow, this is a big class. And now it's a big class of lovely young adults ready to take on the world. I want to wish you well. I want to congratulate you on your accomplishments. And just tell you to go be the best you can be for yourselves and for the world. All right, bye.
Favorite high school memories? I gotta give it to the homecoming pep rallies and the parades and the games. And also anything from Miss Selzberg's English class, because it's a whole different world in that room.
Hey, class of 2020, a few quick tips before you go. Handle adversity, be confident in yourself, and never be satisfied. Congratulations, guys.
My favorite Wells High School memory was definitely going to Friday night football games with my friends.
The meaning of perfect vision, total clarity, no obstacles in the way. But in these uncertain times, you may feel that definition is all wrong. Let me tell you something. After knowing all of you, some of you for many years, that definition of 2020 is exactly right. You will all make this world a brighter place to live in. the vision of your future couldn't be any clearer. You are all a blessing. Take care.
My favorite high school memory would have to be any AP biology class in junior year, just because every day was really entertaining.
Hi, seniors. Congratulations. Sorry this is so weird for you, but you're making the best of it. A lot of you are my first class ever. Congratulations, and I wish you all the best of luck.
My favorite high school memory would have to be when Ms. Salzberg threw a potluck for Gwen and I's birthday.
Congratulations, class of 2020. Whatever your next step is, college, the military, a job, or whatever, you'll do fine. And always remember, no effort you make is ever wasted.
Two things that I liked most about high school were going to States and football for 3 years and hanging out in Miss Knight's room watching movies because I had nothing else better to do.
To the class of 2020, I want to wish you the very best as you begin your next chapter. Take care and conquer the world.
My favorite memory is the class of 2020 senior skip days. Peace.
The class of 2020 warriors, despite this year's craziness, we are so proud of you. Congratulations. Go make your mark.
I'd say my favorite high school memories are Miss Salzberg's class in junior year. I always had fun in that class. Every day was a new experience. She was probably one of the best teachers I've ever had. My other favorite memory was the STEM engineering class I also took in junior year. It was actually a class I enjoyed doing the work in, and it was an actual topic I was interested in.
Congratulations, graduates of the class of 2020, the most memorable year in Wells High School history. We send you off with love and all best wishes.
My favorite high school memory would have to be playing unified basketball with all of my friends, making all the friends that I know and love, and making as many memories as I can with all my teachers.
Hi, congratulations, seniors. Special shout out to Anthony, Ben, and Garth. I will miss you, and I wish you the best of luck. Take care.
One of my favorite memories from high school would have to be senior homecoming, when we not only killed the pep rally and the lip sync and the games and everything, but I was able to be homecoming queen with one of my best friends giving us the king.
Congratulations, class of 2020. I'm so very proud of all of you. It's been a fun 4 years working with you and seeing many of you from fifth grade through senior year grow and learn along the way, but most excited about what you chose to do for your future. Best of luck, and I hope that you all come back and say hello to us.
First off, I want to thank my family for helping me through high school. I want to thank my teachers as well for putting up with me. That's the memory. I don't have just one. I have a lot of fun memories with my friends, and I hope I can stay in touch with them in the future.
Hey, class of 2020. Hey, we're very proud to be your class advisors. Think about what we've gone through all together, right? We started with our floats as freshmen. It was okay. We did pretty well in competitions. Then we went on to our sophomore year, then another float and all that stuff, and then started playing our prom. Prom, outstanding. One of the better ones we had. Then we come into our last year with not a lot of pressure on us to do a lot of things because we were everything. And then all of a sudden, They throw this virus at us. But what do? We stick together and we get it done. And now we've had a great couple of days here of graduation, going on stage. Then we're gonna have our parade, and then we're gonna have our drive-in, and everything's gonna be greatly remembered. You'll be the one class that will always remember their graduation. Congratulations. Come back and see us again sometime.
Congrats, class of 2020. Hey boys, what was the best part of high school?
Probably senior year track, launch,
undefeated senior year baseball season, baby. State champs.
Study hall too, that was pretty fun.
That was hard.
Hand of food, lunch trip, swing back. Yeah. Probably your favorite part.
Class of 2020, baby.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, I can't believe that.
Congratulations, class of 2020. You nailed it.
This was a very special year. We had a record-breaking 69 student applications in the scholarship pool this year. Jody Lawler, one of our guidance secretaries, did all of the work. She organized, communicated, and led the charge. Thanks to her tireless efforts, you made this process work in a COVID-19 contactless way this special year. Also, thanks to our hardworking Superintendent Jim Daly for his strong leadership for all the district during these unprecedented times. Thanks for the support of the school board, Chair Helena Ackerman, and the entire board, and Jen Luia, who did all the slides for tonight's show, spent countless hours doing it. Thank you, Jen. And of course, special thanks to our leaders, Principal Eileen Sheehy and Josh Gould, who had to step up during this time and lead us. As usual, the Wells community stepped up, and even during uncertain times, they gave a tremendous amount of money, close to $100,000 going to the class of 2020. Remember, we are all warriors. Stay strong and good night.